Hello guys, this is me Venkat and welcome you all. Today we are going to talk about prision recalls, which is alternative to ROC curve and which helps us in the situation of imbalanced test results. And now the instructor will continue and thank you. Please subscribe to Physics Academy.
Good evening friends, our next topic about precision recall curves. Actually, what is precision recall curves, what are they and how are they used in data science, in machine learning? That is our present presentation. I am talking about precision recall curves. This article demonstrates that adding a lot of patients without disease and with low test results onto a study may improve the ROC curve significantly without any improvement in sensitivity or in positive predictive value of the parameter evaluator. Precision recall curves are not impacted by the addition of the patients without disease and with low test results. It is highly recommended to use. If you use ROC curve for imbalanced data, that means if your bad prognosis is 30 and your good prognosis is 100, then automatically between positive and negative patients, that is an imbalance exists. If the imbalance exists, then automatically using ROC curve, we will not get a proper predictive value and sensitivity. But if you use the precision recall curves, or definitely we will have a lot of precision regarding the prediction. The precision recall curves are not impacted by the addition of patients without disease and with low test results. It is highly recommended to use precision recall curves as a supplement to the routinely used ROC curves to get the full picture when evaluating and comparing the tests. Here I am going to tell some of the abbreviations and definitions which we are going to use in this presentation. FN means false negative, a number of persons with disease who have a negative test result with the assay in question. FP, that is a false positive, a number of persons without disease who have a positive results with assay in question. And FPR, false positive rate, fraction of persons without disease who have a positive test result with the assay in question, calculated as 100% minus specificity. PPV, positive predictive value, fraction of persons with a positive test result who do have the disease, calculated as true positive dividing by true positive plus false positive. Again, PRC, precision recall curve. A plot of precision is equal to PPV versus recall is equal to sensitivity for all potential cutoffs for a test. We will tell potential cutoff or optimal cutoff, and precision identical to PPV, and prevalence fraction of persons with disease in the tested population. Recall identical to sensitivity. ROC curve, receiver operating characteristic curve, a plot of true positive fraction is equal to sensitivity versus false positive fraction is equal to 1 minus specificity for all potential cutoffs for a test. Sensitivity, again fraction of persons with disease who get a positive test result, that means who has got a bad prognosis, with the assay in question, calculated as TP, true positive dividing by true positive plus false negative. And specificity, fraction of persons without disease. That means they don't have any disease, they are good prognosis. Their prognosis, their diagnosis is good. Who get a negative test results with the assay in question, calculated as true negative dividing by true negative plus false positive. True negative number of persons without disease who have a negative test results with the assay in question. True positive number of persons with disease who have a positive test results with assay in question. TPR true positive rate identical to sensitivity. Again, we will go for background of this presentation. In most situations, when biochemical tests are performance evaluated, the data obtained is heavily skewed or imbalanced. That is, most of the subjects tested belong to the group of patients who do not have the disease condition tested for. Typical disease prevalences are in the range of 10%. It means that only 10% of the patients presenting with symptoms suggesting a particular disease will be finally diagnosed as having that disease, and 90% do not have the disease. Continue to my previous. When the clinical performance of a biochemical test is evaluated, a receiver operating character curve is often used. The ROC curve shows a graphical way the connection trade-off between the clinical sensitivity and specificity of for every possible cutoff, optimal cutoff for a test or a combination of tests, and the area under ROC curve gives an idea about the benefit of using the test in question. Area under the receiving operating characteristic curve gives an idea about the benefit of using the test in question. However, visual representation, interpretation, and comparison of ROC curves based on imbalanced data sets can be misleading. Suppose my data is imbalanced. Suppose I am having 50 bad prognosis and 50 good prognosis, then definitely you can use the ROC curve. However, visual interpretation and comparison of ROC curve based on imbalanced data sets, that means my positive, that means bad prognosis of the data is 30 and I am having 70, that means good prognosis. An alternative to your ROC curve is a precision recall curve. Usually it is called as PRC. It is used less frequently than ROC curves, but as we shall see, PRC might be a better choice for imbalanced data sets. Mostly, even for imbalanced also, we are using ROC curve only, but that is quite misleading. That is why we recommend precision recall curve. It is an alternative to ROC curve in such a situation, imbalanced data sets. How to make a precision recall curve? To make a PRC, you have to be familiar with the concepts of true positive, true negative, false positive, and false negative. In abbreviations also, we have clearly discussed about all these things. However, you don't use the true negatives for making the PRC. The concepts are used when you compare the results of the test with the clinical truth. That means clinical. What is clinical truth? Clinical truth is whether it is a bad prognosis or good prognosis. That is a clinician will decide based on such evidential circumstances, which is established by use of the diagnostic procedures not involving the test in question. Here disease and here left is test. So true positive TP, false positive FP, and positive predictive value and false vector. This diagram, this table one, comparing method with the clinical truth. PRC. Before you make a table like table one, you have to decide your cutoff for distinguishing persons with from those without disease. The cutoff determines the clinical sensitivity, fraction of true positives to all with the disease, and specificity, fraction of true negatives to all without disease, that means good prognosis. When you change the cutoff, you will get other values for true positives and negatives and false positive and negatives. But the number of all with disease is the same, and so is the number of all without disease. Continued. A precision recall curve shows the relationship between precision, positive predictive value, and recall sensitivity for every possible cutoff. The PRC is a graph with the x-axis showing recall is equal to sensitivity is equal to TP dividing by TP plus FN. The y-axis is showing the precision positive predictive value. Thus, every point on the PRC represents a chosen cutoff, even though you cannot see this cutoff. What you can see is the precision and the recall that you will get when you choose this cutoff. To make PRC from your data, you start by ranking all the results and linking each value to the diagnosis. This is yes or no. To make PRC from your data, you start by ranking all the results in the linking, all the results and linking each value to the diagnosis. This is yes or no. Here, ID, that ID is based on topmost parameter concentration of a lab value is 33.63. So, we have given rank as 1. Okay. The top least value of the parameter of concentration, we are giving ID as 160. So, top 1, the disease, what is clinical disease results? Here, yes. And top least, what is the results? No. Rank the data with diagnosis, with respect to diagnosis. PRC. Precision recall curves are often zigzag curves, frequently going up and down. Therefore, a precision recall curves tend to cross each other much more frequently than ROC curves. In ROC curve, suppose if you are having two diagnostic tool, that means it will go parallelly, but here it will cross over. This can make comparisons between curves challenging. However, curves close to the PRC for a perfect text, see later, have a better performance level than the ones closest to the baseline. In other words, a curve above the other curve has a better performance level. This is the PRC data and other parameters measurements. Now the curve is constructed by plotting the data pairs for precision and recall. Precision recall curves are often zigzag curves, frequently going up and down. Here, see the difference between ROC curves and precision recall curves. Precision recall curves recall x-axis true positive dividing by true positive plus false negative. Whereas here, x-axis is 1 minus specificity, false positive dividing by false positive plus true negative. And y-axis precision, true positive dividing by true positive plus false positive. Sensitivity is true positive dividing by true positive plus false negative. Why precision recall curves are better than ROC curves in imbalanced populations? In the following, we will look at the hypothetical parameter C. We look at a balanced data sheet and an imbalanced data set. The imbalanced data set contains 80 results from a person with disease and 80 results from a person without disease. The imbalanced data set contains and the same individual results as the balanced data set, in addition to it contains 640 results from persons without disease. All the additional 640 results are below the lowest sample in the balanced data sheet. Balanced left versus imbalanced right data set. Balanced versus imbalanced dataset precision recall cows. This is the model. Inferences. The imbalanced data set gives a much better ROC curve closer to the upper left corner compared to the balanced data set. Even though the imbalanced data set contains all the same individual results as the balanced data set. And in addition, it contains 640 results from a person without disease, and all those additional 640 results are below the lowest sample in the balanced data set. However, if you look at the precision recall curves, the two curves are completely overlapping. The only difference is that at recall sensitivity is equal to 1, the precision PPV drops to 0.1 for the imbalanced data set, while it is 0.5 for the delta balanced data sets. The general assumption has so far been that if you compare the area under curves for two tests, you would see the real differences in diagnostic performances. You may ask yourself, what would you like to know about a test? For a diagnostic test, you would call, first of all, you like to know the sensitivity is equal to recall, because you want to be sure that the result test identifies the vast majority of persons with a disease as having the diseases. Then you would like to know the positive predictive value is equal to precision, because the PPV tells you how sure you can be when you have a positive result that the person actually has the disease. Thus, you know how good the test is at discriminating persons with disease from those without disease. The example presented above clearly shows that an imbalanced data set with a large fraction of persons without disease in the test population will make a ROC curve look better than it would be in a balanced data set with fewer persons without disease. Suppose imbalanced data is converted into balanced data, automatically you will have a better ROC curve. This calls for a caution when comparing ROC curves for different parameters between studies. The example also shows the precision recall curves are not impacted by imbalanced data sets. It will not, the main reason, the main secret of this, the precision recall curves are not impacted means by imbalanced data set, it will not affect the precision recall curves. But imbalanced data sets will affect the ROC curves. And thus, there should be encouraged as a supplement to the routinely used ROC curves. If you are having imbalance, that means your bad prognosis or good prognosis not equal, then you can go for precision recall curves. Conclusion. Saito and Rechnsmeyer 2015 found in a literature analysis that ROC curves are very popular. Their popularity has been increased for the last decade, and they are the most widely used evaluation method with imbalanced data. Based on their models for how to compare performance to others, conclude that choosing the main evaluation method from ROC to PRC, precision recall curve, may influence many studies. That is this case has been shown here. The graphs presented for the hypothetical data sets above clearly demonstrate that adding a lot of patients without disease and with low test results to may improve the ROC curve. The precision recall curves were not impacted by the addition of the patients without disease and with the two low test results. Thus, it can be highly recommended to use PRC, precision recall curve, as a supplement to the routinely used ROC curves to get the full picture when evaluating and comparing tests. Thank you, my dear friends. I am closing this. Thank you. Namaskar.